Hi, I'm Ryan Lestrange with the Monday Word, and my Monday word for you is, it's not over. I was spending some time with the Lord, and He began to speak to me to release encouragement to the body of Christ that it's not over. You know, the enemy loves to place a mantle of defeat on you and tell you it's over. Many people in the Bible, it looked like it was over. The woman with the issue of blood, it looked over. Blind Bartimaeus, it looked like it was over. But guess what? God had a powerful relaunch for them. And I believe God has a powerful relaunch for you. I hear the Spirit of the Lord saying this to me today. For every false start, there is an authentic launch. Some move before the time. They receive flattering words only to be greatly disappointed. But I am binding up their wounds and I am reviving them, says the Lord. I am reigniting the fire of destiny upon them. I am relaunching them for the next phase, says the Spirit of the Lord. The time shall be redeemed. The enemy has been screaming, it's over, but I am saying it's just beginning. I sense that and hear that for you today, that many moved. God spoke to you. Someone prophesied to you. Some of it was flattering words, but you moved prematurely and you fell on your face. The timing was off, but the original intent was on point, and the Lord is reviving that plan. The Lord is reviving that purpose. The Lord is reviving that destiny. I sense in my spirit the Lord saying, it's time for relaunch. The word relaunch means to launch again. I see some of you are about to be relaunched. There's some things you stepped into. You're about to relaunch. There's ministries about to be relaunched. There's businesses about to be relaunched. There are destinies about to be relaunched. It's time that you grab some of those dormant prophetic words and relaunch them and pull them up again. To relaunch means to start again. It means to set in motion. There's some prophetic purposes, some prophetic destinies that the Lord wants to set in motion. It means to make available again. Now, as the Lord was speaking this to me, He took me to Ephesians 5, 15 and 16. It says, see then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise. That word circumspectly means with eyes all around. But here's what I want to focus on. Verse 16, redeeming the time because the days are evil. The Greek word there for redeeming, it means completely out from, to intensify. It means to buy up at the marketplace, to buy back, to take out from the powers of hell and bring it into the kingdom. It's time for the redemption of time. That's the relaunch. There was timing issues. You stepped out and it didn't work, but there's a relaunch. There's a redemption of the time in this Kairos, in this set time. Some things are about to be redeemed. It means to make the most of the present opportunity, to recognize its future gain. I sense a wind of the Spirit on recognition of prophetic timing and prophetic purposes of relaunch in your life, of relaunch in your business. It's time for things that you thought were dead to be revived, things that you thought were dead to be relaunched. And so I just say over you, it's not over. Hell's saying it's over, but I say it's not over. There's a redemption of time. There's a redemption of plan. There's a redemption of purpose coming to your life that you're going to seize this opportunity. You're going to sense the prophetic significance and you're going to move in it in the name of Jesus. So Father, I thank you for this word of the Lord. I prophesy the relaunch. I prophesy the redemption of time. And I boldly declare it's not over. Whatever you said is going to be established and come forth with strength, with power, and velocity. In Jesus' name, amen.